CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 3.1, Explain the Purpose of Operating Systems. Hypervisor. I know that I am expected to teach about hypervisors in this video, but I can serve you better by teaching about the broader topic of virtualization. For most, it is assumed that a single computing device can only run a single operating system at a time. And for a long time, that was true. But with modern computing, a new feature called virtualization has unlocked the ability for a single computing device to divide and share its resources in order to simultaneously run multiple operating systems. With virtualization, there are two common methods of deployment. The first virtualization setup starts with the computing device, without an operating system installed. This will be represented by the empty green box behind me. Within this computing device, we will have hardware. This will include items like the CPU, RAM, and storage drives. And inside of a virtualized environment, this computing device is often called the host device. Next, we will need a hypervisor. A hypervisor manages the virtualization environment and facilitates interactions with the host device's hardware. With hypervisors, there are two types. With this virtualization setup, we will be using a Type 1 hypervisor. A Type 1 hypervisor, also referred to as a bare metal hypervisor, is a purpose-built operating system that is installed directly on the host device as the host device's OS, and this will be the hypervisor managing our virtualization environment and facilitating interactions with the host device's hardware. With the hypervisor in place, we can now complete our virtualization setup with the installation of virtual machines, or VMs for short. Virtual machines are simulated computer systems created by the hypervisor that allows you to run multiple independent operating systems and applications on a single physical computer simultaneously. Each virtual machine acts as a self-contained, isolated environment, complete with its own virtual hardware and resources, allowing it to run like a separate computing device from within the host device. Now for our next virtualization setup. Again, I will start with the computing device or host device, and I will use the same empty green box behind me in order to represent it. This computing device will still have hardware, to include items like the CPU, RAM, and storage drives. And we will still refer to this computing device as the host device. Now here is where we will differ from the first setup. Instead of installing a Type 1 hypervisor, or bare metal hypervisor, as the host device's OS, we will install an OS like Linux, Windows, or macOS. So effectively, we have an extra virtualization layer in our setup. Next, we will still need a hypervisor to manage our virtualization environment and facilitate interactions with the host device's hardware and network. So instead of a Type 1 hypervisor, we are going to install a Type 2 hypervisor. A Type 2 hypervisor runs as a software application installed on the host operating system just like any other software application. In this scenario, the host operating system will retain direct control of the host device's hardware, and the hypervisor must request use of it through the host OS. Otherwise, it will still behave the same as a Type 1 hypervisor. With our Type 2 hypervisor in place, we can now complete our virtualization setup with the installation of virtual machines. And in case you are wondering what this might look like in use, here is a screenshot of a host device, with Windows 10 installed on it as the host OS. A Type 2 hypervisor was then installed on the Windows 10 host OS as a software application. This Type 2 hypervisor was then used to start up a virtual machine that utilizes a Linux operating system, which can now be operated from within the window here. The Linux device will behave the same as if it was installed on its own separate computing device, thanks to the power of virtualization. By using a hypervisor to create virtual machines, we have an operating system designed to manage other operating systems. So where else might this technology be used? Well, a very common scenario is in a data center. Here, a hypervisor can be used to create and manage multiple virtual machines on a powerful server, enabling efficient resource utilization and consolidation of various workloads, such as web servers, databases, and application servers, on the same hardware. This also reduces the space requirement or physical footprint needed to store computer hardware. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.